एटलीस्ट रीडिंग सिंगल बुक 3 times इज द बेसिक मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट दैट वन शुड डू. हाउएवर फॉर बुक्स लाइक लक्ष्मीकांत आई थिंक बाय द टाइम आई हैव रिटन माय थर्ड अटेम्प्ट आई हैव एटलीस्ट रेड इट 10 times. So for prelims, I read only the basic books. That is, for history, Spectrum is there. For polity, Lakshmikant is there. For geography, NCERTs are there. In fact, NCERTs are there for every subject. So I just followed the basic standard books, and I did not make any notes for prelims because I realized that note making was something that was not my thing. I would remember it better if I read it in printed format in a book. However, I did note down certain points which I felt were extra or which I got from somewhere on an online format on OneNote. So that was my prelims preparation tally.
Apala, students come to us and they always say that I'm having a lot of error problem. My accuracy is very less. We say often end up saying as mentors that, you know, you revise more. How many times were you able to revise your basic books?
So I think at least reading a single book 3 times is the basic minimum requirement that one should do. However, for books like Lakshmikant, I think by the time I have written my third attempt, I have at least read it 10 times. So and still, if I read it today, I'll find something or the other which I might not be remembering. So I think revise as much as you can. There is no minimum or maximum limit. Just do it as much as you can.
In the prelims examination, what do you think is an optimal number of questions that we need to attempt?
Yes, sir. This is something that I did work upon for myself also. For me, I think opting 90 plus questions was good, but that depends from person to person. For example, in my previous attempt, I attempted around 75 questions and that did not work for me. Although I will, those questions were the ones which I was like positive about, but still somehow I failed to clear prelims. So whenever I attempted more than 90, I felt that I was scoring better. So I think mocks are the perfect time to decide the range which you should attempt. And you should have a basic range in mind at the back of your mind for a certain time. But at the time of the exam, it actually depends on the paper. If it is a very tough paper, then you might attempt less. And if it is very easy, then you can attempt even more than 95. But having a little some strategy at the back of your head might help.